March 8th, I would like to inform everyone that it's International Women's Day, and Mermaid Marjan, old Mermaid Marjan, who will soon be 61, is here with the Magic Mermaid at Isla Natural. I just finished a meal. I love Japanese cuisine, and I don't eat any seafood or fish because I've been a vegan since the age of 10, but they have vegan sushi here, so I ate that. And one thing which is important, again, as an example of daily things we can do to reduce and reuse and create less trash, although this is compostable, nothing is 100% biodegradable. And statistics have shown that when people know that what they're using is compostable, they actually trash more, which is not good. So what I'm going to do with this, I have my shopping bag here. So I'm going to put this with the chopsticks that I use. I'm going to take this home and the sauce back too, and I'm going to reuse them. And I've been doing that all along. Give it to other people on my farm to use too when they want to store food. So it won't go into the compostable trash or mixed recycling for any time soon. And this is what we can do. Now, many people don't know when you're drinking coconuts or where you go and order a drink or a smoothie, please say, I don't want a straw. What if you have access to papaya trees? What I use on our farm is to chop down a papaya leaf. The stalks of papaya leaves are hollow. And if you chop them, they make excellent straw. And then once you're finished with it, you can throw it in your compost bin. Okay, or just compost it directly in the ground. So these are all little things we can do on this International Women's Day to save what's left of our ailing planet.
That's wonderful. And I think that's good when you bring it into the everyday. Like you did about not asking for straws and reusing what you already used. I think you're really hitting it head on about, it's our minds. We have to change our minds to help the planet in the ways that we help the planet, the best that each one of us can do. And you were saying drive less, carpooling, buses, walking, all of this, asking. This is my idea, asking the government to do more bike lanes so it's safe for people to bicycle where they need to go. And we were talking earlier about what would be some good ideas for people that are changing and wanting to go vegan. Like in a day, what are some of the things that you eat in a day that represents a good vegan diet?
All right. Magic Mermaid, before going into my little diet, just two things I wanted to emphasize. I was very happy to hear just today in the news that Hawaii is introducing electric buses. We definitely have to encourage our politicians establish a better transportation system.
Okay, yes, I agree.
I was born and raised in Switzerland, and in Switzerland you can survive. Actually, having a car is an injury. Can get everywhere. In most Western European countries, the public transportation is so good that people basically don't need a car. You know, this is a car country, I can understand. Habits are difficult to change. Eating habits are the most difficult to change.
Right.
But it's not impossible. If you realize the harm you're doing to yourself, I mean, it's absolutely now scientifically proven by medical doctors that the three dietary causes of cancer are sugar, red meat, and lactose. So these are the three dietary causes that you can eliminate. There
right,
are other
right.
causes, of course.
Right.
Stress, asbestos, radiation, blah, blah, blah. So as a vegan, you know, I have a very varied diet. You know, I have incorporated different cuisines around the world, from Japanese, Indian, Turkish, Greek. And I'm in Hawaii with this kind of temperature. My main diet is fruit. So I usually get up in the morning and my main meal is breakfast. I eat like an elephant. My breakfast, I have a huge bowl of fruit that I freshly harvest from the fruit trees.
Oh, nice.
From our land.
Oh, good.
I'm very lucky because I live in that environment. I don't buy mainland fruit. Sometimes I do, like organic blueberries. Every once in a while, I have a craving for cherries. I love cherries.
Oh yeah, me too.
But you know, my when I'm here, I basically love and eat whatever's available on the land. Mm-hmm. So my morning is mainly fruit.
Okay.
Nuts,
oh yeah.
Kinds of nuts, and I make my own muesli. Okay, so that's my main breakfast. Then mm-hmm. sometimes in the morning, on cold morning days, I actually have a Japanese breakfast, which is called a kayu, but I make it with organic brown rice. And then I add seaweed, sea kelp, and tofu.
Oh, that sounds good.
Or tempeh.
Nice.
I eat that.
Right.
So, and then I also sometimes like a good old American breakfast. I mm-hmm. eat vegan waffles. Mm-hmm. With maple syrup. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I make myself vegan pancakes using, mm-hmm. Either almond milk or almond grease, which has the highest amount of calcium. And I also sunbathe every day because mm-hmm. I love sunbathing. I must have been, that's what mermaids do.
Yes.
When we come out
yes.
of the water.
And I must say, you do look really young and beautiful.
And most people are afraid for the sun, but if you don't get burned, that's why if you have a natural tan like I do right now, you're basically protected. So what you have to do is basically hydrate your skin. Mm-hmm. And you know, some people who have freckles and red hair, and then a lot of beauty spots. Mm-hmm. I had a dermatologist friend who said those people must be careful because they're genetically predisposed to cancer or melanoma.
Okay.
But you know, even blonde hair, very white people, if they tan gradually, it's healthy for you, especially women our age. Mm-hmm. Don't get osteoporosis and the vitamin D that we have in our food gets fully absorbed when we get natural UV light, ultraviolet light.
Right.
But scientific evidence has shown that in sun-deprived countries, even with added vitamin D, people still suffer from osteoporosis. That was the case with my mother, with my late mother. And
you got to keep the bones strong,
yes.
whatever way we can.
So,
someone was saying Brazil nuts.
That people in sun-drenched countries, you know, the island countries, even with minimal calcium they have in their diet, there's little cases of osteoporosis because the minimum calcium that they take is fully absorbed with the help of the UV light.
Wow.
So go in the sun. I always suntan.
And you did the coconut oil and the shea butter, you said.
And I use zinc oxide. Island Naturals right next door has a whole, a few sunscreens and sunblocks that are free of chemicals that not only harm the corals, but also if you search, you will see that the same chemicals like oxybenzone and oxycontin are carcinogenic.
Okay.
This is what the drug companies don't tell you.
Right.
That these sunblocks, most of them, are carcinogenic. So please don't use those.
Right. So
and
the zinc oxide, yeah.
Zinc oxide. And
where do you use the zinc oxide when you use it?
On my body, or mainly on my face, because that's your most sensitive part.
Okay, so when you sunbathe, you usually put zinc oxide on your face to protect your face.
Yes, and then I use either mainly coconut oil or shea butter on the rest of my body.
Oh, okay, so you let yourself tan, but not your face. You protect your face.
No, I let everything tan.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, including my face.
Uh-huh, so what do you use the zinc oxide you...
I just put a little amount on my face.
Oh, okay, but can you still get a tan through the zinc
of course,
oxide?
It's
oh, okay. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's not a sunblock.
Okay, I wasn't sure how that one worked.
Yes. And then one thing that also helps you tan faster and safer is if 1 month before you actually start tanning, if you drink fresh carrot juice.
Oh, okay.
But fresh carrot juice has melamine and it will beta carotene will give your body the necessary ingredients to start to accelerate the tanning process.
Oh, wow.
Safely.
Okay.
And actually, if you drink one or two cups of fresh freshly, you know, squeezed carrot juice.
Mm-hmm.
By the end of the month, you will actually see that your skin has an orange tinge to it.
Wow, okay.
That's from the better carotene.
Wow.
And that's a tip that one of my dermatologist friends gave me a long time ago when I was flying from cold.